Hello and good morning. Happy Friday to you all. This is Foreverwell Friday. My name is Sarah. It is great to be here with you today, and I hope you're having a wonderful day. Today we're going to be doing a cardio and strength circuit. So we're going to go back and forth between some cardio blocks and strength blocks. All you need to do is have a set of weights, have them handy and close by, and we'll just alternate between the two. You might also want to have a water bottle, and then room to move. So you need to have some space around you so you have room to move forward, backward, sideways, and get that cardio and heart rate going, and get a little bit of strength work all at the same time. So we've got 30 minutes of workout today, so it's time to get to it right now. I'm just going to hit my music and we'll be ready to go. And let me just do that over here. Here we go. All right, I want you to pull up tall, nice tall back, tall shoulders. Draw those abs in and march. Pump those arms and keep it moving. Remember to pay attention to that posture throughout the workout. You want to have a nice tall back, keeping that alignment. Shoulders over hips, hips over knees, and knees over ankles. Now lift those knees a little higher. Take them up. Keep it going. Give me four more. Four, three, two, take it wide. Take it out. Bring it up. Bring it back in. Take it in. Two more. Back wide. Out. New move. Squat tap. Down and up. I want you to pull those arms up. In. Close. Squat tap. Squat tap. Lift. Last two. Get ready. New move. Step touch. Step touch. We're gonna keep it right here. I'm gonna check, see how things are going. You guys can hear me all right. How's the music? This is your opportunity to let me know. Hey, Julie, Sarah, Debbie, Mary, great to have you. Step touch. Looks like music and sound are doing well. Let's add those arms. Pull, pull. So think of bringing those elbows up to the shoulders, reaching a little higher. Four. Three, get ready, new move coming up. Two steps, two. We're gonna keep it going with a full reach. Two, starting to feel that heart rate climb just a little bit more when we get those arms going a little bigger and we move a little further. Two steps each way. One more round. Now, adding on, two steps, hold the march, right here. Two steps, hold that march, two steps, and march it, five, six, seven, eight, two steps. March, take it back. Perfect. One more round, two steps, and hold that march, and stay right here for four, three, single tap. Let's go, take it up. Same move with those arms that we started with. Bring those elbows up. Watch that shoulder joint. If reaching higher bothers or aggravates that shoulder, keep it closer. Four to go. Just tap. Three. Two. Get ready. Single knees. Let's go. Arms here or up, pull, lift, reach, four to go, four, three, two, one more, new move coming up, step side, just hold, other side, so I'm stepping out, coming in, hold and in, remember, pay attention to that posture, good strong alignment, step, once you have it, you can take it a little deeper. Sink, lift. This isn't a full squat, just a quarter of the way. Make sure that you plant your feet steady. Out, one more, and hold back to the march right here. Let's do all that through on the other side. Keep it going. with a 1, 2, 3 tap. Let's go. 1, 2, 3 tap. 1, 2, 3 tap. So you're marching 3 times, tapping once to the front. Last one. Hold that march this side. Stay. Right here. Stay. You're on your left leg. Pump those arms. Keep it moving. Take it wide. Take it out. Now, when you go wide, I want you to come down just a little lower. Sink into those legs. Bring it back up. Now, lift tall. March in. So think of working high to low. Feel that contrast in that movement. Go wide. Take it down. Load those legs. 4, 3, 2, bring it in right here and stay. Pump. Keep those arms moving. Give me 4 more. 3, 2, side to side, step touch right here. Start with the feet. Always build the feet first. Once you have the feet, then you can start to think about those arms. Bringing the elbow up, lift. Stand up, lift tall. Once we start to think about choreography, we start to forget about the form. But I want you to stay up and lifted, getting ready. 2 steps, here we go. 2, 2. Take it back, 2 steps. Start to reach it higher as you go. 1 more round, and we're gonna come back to the march. Stay. Let's put those pieces together. 2 steps and 4 marches. Let's go. 2, march, 4, 3, 2. 2 steps. March, 4, 3, 2. Take it back. 2, march it, 4, 3, 2. Take it back. Hopefully you're starting to feel that pattern. March. 1 more round. Hold it right here. Single taps. Lift, lift, lift. Up. Reach those arms. Press it. Up. Adding on. Single knees. Lift. When you lift that knee, you're actually gonna tuck back just a little bit and brace those abdominals. Lift, lift. Feeling good? Reach it. Press it up through those fingertips and stretch high. Great way to build intensity is to think about the lift, because you get intensity without impact. 4 to go. 4, 3, 2, 1 more. Hold that march, stay, and give me a squat tap, down and up. Can you drop that squat a little deeper? Finishing this warm up, bring those arms in, up and down. 4 to go, 4, 3, 2, and march, stay. Right here, remember that side squat, out and in. We're going back. We start with just the step. Plant the feet, even pressure between the legs. When you have it, sink it, lift. Again. 1 more round. Take it up, march. 1, 2, 3 with the tap. Left, right, left. Good. 1, 2, 3. Reset the posture. Warm up is done. Time to head for our first set. We're gonna grab our weights, and this set is gonna keep the heart rate going, but it's gonna work upper body and lower body all at the same time. So grab your weights. Hey Trudy, hey Barb, great to see you on. Roll those shoulders back, lift the arms up, turn the feet out just a little bit. Brace and hold, ready, squat and press. Sink, lift. When you press, you wanna brace those abdominals in. Lost my train of thought there. Down and up. Good. 4 more. Sink. Press. You can leave out the press if you like. 1 more round. Hold right here. Take those arms down. 1 foot forward. Reverse flies. moving from shoulders to the back. Pull, open, return, lift, back. Squeeze, pull, pinch those shoulder blades together. That work is in the back side. One more. Now hold right here. Step in and step. Left foot, back, right foot. Now we're not doing a lunge, but we are doing a big step. So from that side angle, you'll see that I'm just taking a big step, working on that push back, keeping that heart rate going, loading that leg. One more time, each side. Ready? Come on back. Hold it up. Round two, squats. With or without the press, you choose. Sink, lift. So again, you could leave out that press and just focus on the legs. Feeling okay? Add those arms. Push, sink, lift, sink, lift. Now watch that range. You might need to shorten that range just a little bit. You can work what feels right for you. One more. Take it down, return. Like I said, you're gonna feel that heart rate climb in that last move. Take it up. So even though we're doing strength training, we're keeping that heart rate going strong. Pull back, return. Pinch the shoulder blades. Lift. Back. That's it. Four more. Four. Try not to rock that upper body. Just let the arms pull back. Last one. Hold, return, release. Set those weights. Back down, crisscross the weights so it roll off and march. Right, left, right, left. All right, second block of cardio. We have a hustle forward and a hustle back with some jumping jacks and leg kicks. Let's go, walk it up. One, two, three, take back. Go again, take it up. One, two, three, we're traveling forward, up and back, four counts. One, two, three, four, and back. Two, three, four. If you have it, you can travel further. You can add those arms. Whatever you want to do to keep that heart rate pumping. Single kicks right here. Kick, right, left, right. Now kick from the hip. Lift, lift. Reach for those arms. Up. Arms to the feet. Cross it, up, up. Last two. One more, take a look. Half jacks. Half jacks are a low impact jack. Watch that shoulder. If it feels okay, you can take it up a little bit. Lift. If you wanna do a full jack here, go right ahead. It's your body, your call. Up, four more, four. Three, two, one more. Hold that march, right side. Excellent. Let's come back to that one, two, three tap that we did previously. One, two, three tap, one, two, three. This is gonna be a quick set of cardio before we head back to the weights. Knee up. One, two, three. One, two, three, knee. Now, when we've got that pattern, I want you to start to build the move. Take it up a little higher. Reach it. One, two, three. Take it up. Now really pull the arm as if it's pulling the leg with it. You can add a little hop here on the end or leave it out. Four, three, two, one more. When we come back, we're gonna hold the march on your left. Stay, stay right here. Bring those knees up a little higher. Get ready for the walk. Let's take it up. One, two, three. Feel it out first. Get a sense of your space, where you can move. Once you have it with the lower body, you add that upper body. Any arms, it doesn't matter to me what you're doing because ultimately these won't change this. It won't change that heart rate. It's the leg work that really matters. Two more to go. Take it up. Last one. When we come back, single kicks to the front. Left, right, up, up. Work from that hip. Pull. When you do that, you have to brace the abdominals. You have to tuck it in, shoulders back, reach. Add just a tiny bit of rotation across and lift. There we go. Get ready for that half. Jack, up, up. Option one, it's always about layers. Option two or layer two, a little bigger. Option three, full lift or full jack, your call. Four left, four, three, two, one more, and hold that march. Stay here, one, two, three with a tap. One, two, three, one, two, three, tap. Once you have that pattern, lift the knee. One, two, three. All right, this is our last piece of this block. One, two, three. Work on that drive up, lift, pull back. One, two, three, reach. One, two, three, take it up. Keep it going. Last two. Hold that march, stay. Grab your weights. We are not gonna take time to pull back. We're gonna keep it moving, grabbing those weights. Take a look. Plie squat. Much wider stance than we had earlier. Shoulders back, sink, lift. I want you to work on that pull up. Again, adjust the depth of the squat for you. You might start higher, feel more comfortable there, but as you feel that range increase, and even as your body warms up, you might find more range. So take it a little deeper. Now hold right here. Up, crisp, cross those weights right in the middle of the body, lift. Now, if you want to keep that load on the legs, you certainly can. Last two. One more. Hold. Walk those feet in. Now, tip forward. Hands back. Push. Return. So, straighten those arms back. Lift. Lower. Lift. Back. Press behind you. Up. Four more. Four. Three. Two, last time. Take it down, return, hands back. Shoulders roll, lift up, squat down. Press it. Great attention to that posture right now. Those weights and the action is gonna wanna pull you forward. I want you to resist against it and stay up. We're working through the legs. Our knees bend, our ankles flex, and our hips bend. Give me two more. Last one. Take it up. Now hold right here. Up, up. Same move, just a little faster. Up, abs braced. Four more. Three, two, and one. Take it down, walk those feet in. Tip back, elbows in, abs braced, ready, push back. Straighten the arm, bend the arm. So as you straighten that arm, you stop right at the hips. Out, back, lift, return, up. Good, four to go, you guys. We're gonna get a total body strength training workout in this round. Last one, and hold, return. Release and roll. Reset, set those weights down and come on back. I wanna get one more set of cardio and one more set of strength. March it, lift, lift. Perfect, now this next set is about agility. We wanna train our body outside of its normal planes of movement, because if we stick to what we've always done, our body stays where it's always been. So we have to do this not only for the body, but for the brain. So take a look, a mambo step is a march. I march front, I march back. So it's a basic march, think of it as right, left, right, left. But what I do is I take one foot forward and then back. And in this case, it's just your right leg, forward and back. Perfect. Last two, and I'm going to add on some rhythm there. A mambo cha-cha. Give it a try. Mambo cha-cha. Mambo cha-cha. Step forward, take it back. Now that cha-cha is a 1-2-3 run. Rock, 1-2-3. Let's build the footwork first. Get comfortable with that. Once you have it, I want you to pull up and pull back, lift. That's it. Now you can start to add those arms. Reach and lift. Pull up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, one more. Hold that march, right leg. Perfect. Keeping it here, we're gonna go to a V-step. Right leg, let's go, take it out. One, and back. Out, out, and back. March, march, in, in. Keep going, lift, and back. One more round, and tap this foot, go left, out. Out, and back. We're gonna go back to that mambo cha-cha. Four to go. We'll start with that marching rhythm. We'll build it in just like we did on the right. Left leg, march it. Start to add that front to back march with the left. We call it a mambo. Mambo front, mambo back. Rock, front to back. But the rhythm, the pattern, left, right, march, back, front. I always think of it as this foot just lifting up and over something. Take it up, take it back. All right, give me two more and get ready for that mambo cha-cha. Ready? Let's go. Take it up, 1, 2, 3. Quick, quick, quick. Remember, footwork first. Up, 1, 2, 3. Rock, 1, 2, 3. Step, quick change. Step, quick change. Once you have it, lift. There you go. Up. Four more. Four. Three. Pull back. Lift tall. Good. Two. One more round each side. Now hold that march and step. Take the arms. Circle them quick. Now take those arms high. Take them down, low. V-step, this side, up, up. We're going wide, wide, narrow, narrow. So remember what we were talking about, that same movement. We're just marching. We're marching left, right. But I'm asking my body and my brain to think and work together. Out, 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 out. One more, switch. Other side, out, out, in. Pull up tall. Keep going. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Last time. Back to the march. Hold those hands. Quick. Take it high. Think of it like a speed bag. We go low. And then if it feels okay on the shoulder, take it up. Take it down. Take it high. Last one. Hold that march. Excellent. Quick set of one more round of strength. Then we have balance and stretch, and we'll be done for the day. So grab your weights. Hey, Nancy. Good to see you for joining me this morning. Take this foot. Step it forward. Now, what I want you to do is come into a lunge position. This knee is over my ankle, and I'm pushing back through that back heel. Now I'm raising my body tall, elbows at my side, lift, down, lift, lower, up, return, up, and back, lift. This hair always gets in the way. Four to go, up. Three, two, one more. Now, hold it down, lean forward, row back. So we're still loading that lower half of the body. But we're working the upper body. Shoulders again. Back. Good. Little activation in the bicep. Not much, but a little bit. But a lot in the back. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Last time. Now hold. Return. Roll back. Lift up just a little bit. Side view. Tall back. Knee over the ankle. Weights at your side. Tap. Tap. I'm loading this front leg with a repeater and really bracing my upper body. So I'm activating that core even more. Four, three, two, and one, and hold. Let's do the same thing on the other side. Activate and hold. Tap it in. That's it. Back, back. Five, four, three, two, and one, and hold. We're gonna finish up that weight on the other side. Lean in and hold. Start with that lunge position. So leaning front into that front leg, knee over the ankle, back leg is strong and straight, but my body is upright. So in this one, I'm not leaning, I'm lifted. Hands at your side. Now, first choice, we stayed with that bent elbow. That's a great option. Remember, it should not bother the shoulder, and if it does, find something else that works. Another option, a little more challenging, arms straight. Lift, pull. Four more. One more. Now hold, return, lean in. So this time, I am taking my body forward. I'm holding and rowing straight back. Good. Squeeze, back, lift. Most of this work is right through the middle of the back. You're gonna feel that work in the leg as well as the core, because we have to stabilize to hold steady. Four more. Control that movement. Three, two, one more. Now hold, release, step in. Hold back, set your weights down. And roll the fingers. We are not done with our workload yet. Some balance training, glute strength training, and abdominal strength. So what I want you to do is hold tight right here, brace in through the middle, but lift that leg behind you. Now, if you feel like you want to hold on to the chair or the wall, you certainly can do that. Hold the posture tall and just lift. It's a small move, pushing that foot behind you. Squeeze, squeeze. Four, three, two, and one. Hold, other side. So you get a little bit of balance training, particularly if you're not using the wall. Even if you are using the wall, try to use it sparingly, just as a guide, and start that back leg. It's tight, it's strong, hips are level. Squeeze, squeeze, lift, lift. It's not a big lift. Five, four, three, two, and one. Return. Hold and stay. Lift, down, up, and back. Good, give me one more lift, and let's stay tall on this next one. Hold it tall. Up on the toes, reach those arms. Hold, release. Take those arms behind you. Let the heels drop, pull back. Feel that stretch across the upper body. Excellent. Take one hand down. Now reach. I want you to think of pushing down with this hand as you lift with that other hand. Tap the back. Add that arm and push. Release. Other side. Lift. Wonderful work today. We are almost there. Just a little bit of flexibility and range of motion here at the end. Tap the back, working on that shoulder range. Stretching out those muscles that we use the most. Five, four, three, two, and one. Take the hands down. Take one foot back, roll the hips under. So tuck the pelvis, feel that pull right through the hip flexors. We did a lot of kicks, a lot of knee up, all that walking. We want to stretch that hip flexor. Take the arms in front. Pull away, stretching that upper back. Step in, other side. Same thing, drop, roll, feel that pull right up the front of the leg, arms pull out. One more deep breath in. And exhale, release, step in, and take a big deep breath all the way up. Stretch tall through the fingertips and return. That is it today, everybody. Thank you all for joining me. Great to be here with you. I will see you probably again in a couple of weeks. We will have classes next week running. I will be out, but you'll have Linda on Monday and Jen on Wednesday. And I believe I might be back in on Friday. I'll check the schedule, but it is online. You can check that schedule at our virtual Y page at the YMCA, Y at Home. Check that out. If you have any questions, you can also text me. I'd be happy to answer any questions you have via Facebook. So let me know how the workout went. So great to be with you, and have a terrific weekend, and I'll see you next time. Take care.